Route 2 is Cloudflare's global object storage with zero egress fees. It provides storage for all your data and files to help you deliver high-performance applications. Whether you need to store large media files, create a data lake, or deliver web assets, Route 2 offers you the flexibility to build any data architecture of your choice. There are different reasons why you may consider using Route 2. Let's highlight some of the common use cases. Today, you can use Route 2 for static hosting, for podcast episodes, storage for cloud native applications, storage for web content, for data lakes, cloud storage output for large batch processes like machine learning model artifacts or data sets, archiving data, or backing up data. Now that we know what Route 2 is, let's see a demo of how to work with it. In this demo, we'll create an Route 2 bucket from Cloudflare's dashboard and perform basic CRUD operations on it. To do that, let's head over to the Cloudflare Route 2 dashboard. Route 2 is a paid feature, but we also allow you sign up for a generous free tier. Before proceeding with the next steps, you should already have access to Route 2. Before we move forward, let's define what an object and a bucket is, because we'll use those terms a lot in this video. Any data, regardless of the content type, is stored as an object. An object is composed of the object itself and the metadata about the object. And every object stored has a unique ID. A bucket, on the other hand, is not tied to physical arrays or disks and may span across multiple sites or regions. It is used for creating a logical abstraction in the object storage system. Now let's create a bucket called podcasts. And the aim here is to store audio files in this bucket so that we can use it in our application. After creating the bucket, we can upload files or folders directly or use the Worker API or S3 compatible API if the data we are trying to upload is over 300 megabytes. After a file upload, you can perform other operations on it like viewing the file, downloading it, or deleting it. You can also make the file publicly accessible, and I'll show you how to do that in the next video. We just created a R2 bucket and uploaded a file to it. Check out the links in the description to learn more about how R2 storage can help you scale and build performance applications, and also information about pricing and storage limits associated with it.